is a business. Heart attack does not come by blocks in the coronary vessels. No.
Okay.
The two are not connected at all. Heart attack comes when your mind is bad. So if you can mind your mind, you can avoid your heart attack to a great extent. Your all four vessels can be blocked. Nothing happens because the vessels were not blocked yesterday. When the doctor frightens you, 100% block of a vessel, it didn't happen yesterday. It happened over the last 25 years. And when the vessel started getting blocked, nature provided bypass. And if you carefully look at the angiogram, you will see a lot of God-given bypass for you. And they're called collaterals. You don't have to worry. They are much better than others because then your heart gets learns to learn to live with less blood supply. That is why I always say it is better to have blocks in the heart, in the coronary vessels. Yes, you said rightly. It's business. It's not a small business. It's a big business.
Most of medicine is a business today, actually. Then.
You are right. Actually, in the corporate culture, if you don't do business, you are not there as a doctor.
You are
thrown out.
Targets. You have
yes,
targets.
Yes. Medicine is a business.
Thank
and
you.
Corporate hospitals are a business. You know, medicine was so bad in 1823 that a thinking doctor started a science journal called The Lancet. He said, I will call it a Lancet because the doctors have become an abscess on the human body. I'm going to cut it and excise and take the pus out. And he did it when 1823. The journal lasted 185 years now. Very famous journal. The present editor said, what has happened to medicine since The Lancet started? So he called Hilary Butler, a historian, medical historian, to study this. She took 2 years to study, and what she wrote at the end was, what was once a bunch of bad doctors in London has now transformed itself into a corporate monstrosity all over the world, killing people left, right, and center. That's medicine.
Thank you, sir.
If it is not a business, it doesn't exist. Yes, madam. No, sit down. Please sit down.
No, sir. It's okay.
Please, for heaven's sake.
Oh, absolutely fine. Good morning, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, good morning.
I just want to ask one thing. Just you said medicine is a business. I have gone through an experience that last year, two years back, I had some severe back pain. Okay, I had been to one very good hospital, like you can say 5-star hospital. And then after my MRI and X-rays and all, the doctor said, you have to do the operation for that. You have to undergo the surgery.
My God, you didn't have it?
No, I didn't
good
have
it. Good thing you didn't have it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you would have been in bed.
Yeah, no. Yeah. So, and he said he had given me that 8 hours operation and all. But I went to some another person, like, and then I just wanted to find out, you know, like second opinion. And then doctor, he asked me to do certain exercises. I have done that. And then he said, no need. Okay, of doing
any another
operation.
Doctor or the same
yeah.
Doctor?
No, another doctor. Another doctor, yeah. Another 5-star hospital.
He's a good doctor.
Very good doctor.
Yeah.
He was the spine surgeon there and the last authority, it seems. So somebody had given me that reference and I had been there. So, and again, this year, some problem I had gone to another regular orthopedics doctor, not to the you can say that so-called
third doctor.
Okay. And that third doctor also said no need of operation. How can that person, that doctor had suggested this? Okay. So this is the story. Now I just want to know that since you are such a great person, I just
want to know. No, I'm a human being.
No, sir. Can a patient has got that right to ask before slipping on the operation table? That I just want to know that exactly what had happened. Is any rule is there in your medical ethics or in our law system? I just want to know because this had happened for many people, even angiography, angioplasty. So many people, they are suffering through this. As you said, medicine is nothing but business. So as a common people, rather human beings, do we have any that kind of system that we can just go and find out whether this operation is needed, whether really there is a blockage, or again we'll flow in the stream. I really want to
it's
find
a good
that
question.
Answer.
I'll give you a very simple solution
yeah.
As a patient.
Yeah.
Number one, never submit yourself to surgery on one opinion.
Okay.
Take a second opinion. Because medicine you can take, if something goes wrong, you can survive.
Yeah.
But surgery, if supposing they had operated on your back, you would have lost your power in the limbs permanently.
Yeah.
I have a doctor who went for this kind of a surgery because I always say never go for back surgery. And he's completely paralyzed now. He's in bed. And poor chap has no wife also, so he is in real trouble. He was my old student, but he is in real deep trouble now. Now, the other thing I would like to say, when you have a backache, never see a doctor. See a physiotherapist. He will cure you with simple physiotherapy. I will give you an example. I had a patient in Chennai who came to see me with the backache. I said, this man requires a physiotherapist. I called the physiotherapist and said, examine him. He went, came back and told me, sir, I told him to remove his thick purse from his back pocket. His pain is gone, sir. If you have a thick purse at the back, when you sit, it presses on your sciatic nerve. So you get a back pain completely. And if the purse is removed, the pain gone. So you must have a sensible doctor. Yes. Never subject yourself to surgery, any kind of surgery, with one opinion. But they'll trick you. What they'll tell is, supposing you say, I don't want an angioplasty now, the surgery done, I'll go and take a second opinion. He says, I don't know, I can't guarantee. You go to the next place, you may die on the way.
Oh.
Which is all not true.
That's not true at all.
Yeah. You can always take a second opinion.
So that's the psychology, no? Like we feel it is emergency and then again we have been cheated.
Amma, if we don't use the psychology, we can't make you a bakra of you.
Okay, yeah, that's also true.
I'll tell you, one of my students, a very good student of mine, passed his MD and joined a 5-star corporate hospital. One day he was seeing a patient in the OP. So he was trying to tell the patient something. Then the cardiac surgeon was passing by. So he called him, come out, I want to talk to you. He went out. He said, see, in a corporate hospital, this is what you do. If you first, when the patient comes, find out who is funding him, whether he has insurance, whether he's got rich parents, whether he has a lot of money. In that case, you refer him to me. I will manage him. Oh. Supposing he doesn't have anything, then you give him whatever you do and send him off. It requires medicines only. So you have to intervene to make money. And we have to make a bakra of you by putting fear into your head. Saying that your vessels are all blocked. I am happy that vessels are blocked. If somebody's vessels are blocked, he'll live long. Oh. I have a chap who came to me 40 years ago with all the 4 vessels blocked in the heart. But so much collaterals he had, his whole angiogram was looking like collaterals. So he came to me. I told him, you don't require anything. You forget about it. And you go home and enjoy life. But his children thought, this village doctor doesn't know. So they were all in America. They took him to America. They took the same angiogram, took him to Mayo Clinic. The Mayo Clinic doctor saw that and said, ask your father to go home, have a peg of whiskey every night and enjoy life. Oh. And now he is 94. 94. Oh. He's still alive. 54 years later. Absolutely fine with all the vessels blocked. Nature is a great doctor. Nature does all the things. And backache for a woman should never go to a doctor. Backache is due to bad posture. Sit straight. All right.
Thank you, sir.
Don't slouch in the chair. Yeah. That's what most of us do. Even I do that. My son says, you advise everybody, but you slouch in the chair.
Thank
Singh
you.
Singh Sab sat now. Sit straight up. Back straight. And when your back is straight, your back is no problem.
Thank you so much.
Welcome. Good afternoon. Yes, young man. Tell me.
You believe that our education system is flawed, and I'm a frustrated student, so I believe the same, but... But then, if it's such a big system, how do you think it will change? Like,
thank you very much. It's a good thing. He thought there is a shortcut. He is a frustrated student. So, I'll give him a solution. As long as the system persists, you have to go through the system and pass your exam. Because if you don't have a degree, nobody bothers about you. But you are right. That degree is useless, as somebody said. But then, you have to have a degree to be somebody. Supposing you talk without having a degree, nobody bothers about you. Supposing I had said this without any one of my qualifications, you would have been laughing at me. Now that I say that, you say, okay, this ass must be knowing something, so he's talking. So have a degree first.